Good morning, everyone. Justin Patton here. So I want to just have a real conversation with you today about why do you do the things that you continuously do and make some of the same decisions and do some of the same behaviors every day that keep you stuck in your life. And the reason I got to thinking about this is because I'm currently going through Iyanla Vanzant's course on forgiveness on Oprah's e-network and the eCourse. I'm highly recommended if you haven't started taking it. But Iyanla, who is like everything to me, said this one line that I've been thinking about for the last several days. She says, "We don't do anything unless it serves a purpose in our life. Because once the experience is over, it's over. We choose to hang on to it. We continue to do the things that we want to do. And the only reason we do that is because it serves a purpose in our life." And most of us just walk around every day, not really without any awareness about why we're doing the things that we're doing. And so, why do you do some of the things that you do? And it got me thinking, there are so many people out there that constantly complain about everything every day, or they complain about their partner, or the current job that they're in, or a friend, or about their financial status, but they don't make changes. So underneath that, what is that behavior serving you? Does it get you the attention that you want from other people? Does it get you remorse from people or empathy from other people? It's serving an emotional purpose for our life. I know a lot of people, I've coached a lot of people in their life who continuously play the victim role, and they beat up that 15, 16, 12-year-old child that they used to be. And we talk about it a lot, and they're like, "Well, I don't want to be a victim," but you're doing that. And what does that serve you in your life today? And they just haven't even thought about it at that level. And I know people who, they're always feeling guilty for something, right? So is it feeling guilty for eating certain things? Is it being, doing certain things sexually? What purpose is those feelings of guilt and remorse serving for you in your life? And then there are other people that make everything about them. So whether they're in a relationship or whether it's in a business situation, they always make it about themselves. And I believe they do that because it serves a purpose in their life. Because if they knew how to do it differently, they would. And so, let me tell you why I think all this craziness I'm talking about is really important. Because I believe that when we understand the purpose that all the actions, feelings, and thoughts that we demonstrate in our life are really what they're rooted to, right? What the purpose behind all those actions, thoughts, and feelings are, then we get stronger emotional awareness in our life. And that's when real personal transformation happens. I'll tell you who I think does it better than anyone, besides Iyanla Vanzant, of course. So, of course, she's my hero. But other than that person, the other hero that I really admire is Chris Powell from Extreme Weight Loss. And if you've ever seen that show, what I love about Chris and his coaching style is that he understands that if you want to change people's behavior, you got to change their mindset. It's not just about the tools and strategies to lose weight, because that is a short-term change. That will not create long-term sustainable change going forward in life. And so he understands that underneath the actions and behaviors is a purpose. There's a reason why people eat the way they do. There's a reason why they choose not to get up and get motivated. There's a reason why they sit on the couch. So understanding and helping people get their own insight and clarity on what action or what benefit is that having for you in your life? Why do you it might not even be a benefit, right? So if you're not doing that, is it because you want people to wait on you because you like the attention? Is it because other people feel sorry for you and that you like the validation that comes along with it? Is it because of your past and the baggage that you've been through? And it was a way for you to feel good, or this is the one thing that you can control in your life. Underneath every one of our behaviors is a purpose. And so we got to get really clear about what that is if we want to change and continue to grow and move forward in our lives. So here's my call to action kind of challenge for you today. I just want you to choose one thing. One thing in your life that you say that I continuously do that maybe I haven't really thought of enough about why I do that behavior. So is it maybe when things get tough in a conversation that you're the kind of person that just gets loud and yell and you just get really pissy with people? Well, why do you do that? Can you get really clear about what that is? Is it maybe that you're not emotionally available for your partner or your friends? You know, if you're not, first of all, you probably know that. And I'm sure if you're not emotionally available, you've been told by people in your life. And is the reason you're not is because if you have to be emotionally available, are people all of a sudden, are you going to have to be vulnerable and deal with some shit in your past that you haven't dealt with? And so what is the purpose behind not being emotionally available to people in your life? Because it's serving a purpose, and that's why you continue to do it. Or the last thing, I just, one of the other ideas I put is, do you feel like you're that person that always has to be in control in your life? And if so, what purpose is it serving? Why do you feel like you always have to be that person? And so I just want you to choose one thing that you're doing in your life this week, or you know that you're doing, to think about this week to get some clarity on it and ask yourself, what purpose is it serving me? Because know that it is, good or bad, it's serving you in some way, and why do you continuously do it? You do not have to come up with it in 5 minutes. I just want you to brainstorm and think about it over the next couple days in your life and say, can you have an aha moment that gives you some clarity about why you do what you do and what you need to do to change and move forward? You know, I always say this, right? Our job is not to wake up and have it all together. Our job is just to show up and be better than yesterday. And being better than yesterday starts by us becoming more emotionally aware about why we do some of the things that we do. And that starts by understanding asking ourselves, what is the purpose that this behavior and this action is serving me in my life? So if it gives you something to think about, if no one tells you today they believe in you, please know that I believe in you. Thank you for going this crazy journey with me. I'm always there for you. If you like the video, you think it's good, if someone else can benefit, like it, share it with other people, leave a comment. I would love to reply back to you. And appreciate all that you do to make this world an amazing place. Continue to do the things that you do in your life. Know that you are where you're supposed to be and learning the lessons that you need to learn. All right? I wish you a wonderful day. I believe in you, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.